Hi there, welcome to the fourth video in this little series that I'm putting together of the Star Trek Online series of starships from Eaglemoss Hero Collector. This one is issue number 5, the USS Buran, NCC 96400. Quick look at the box, a bit of artwork from the magazine inside. Same as before, exactly the same form as the other boxes, obviously. Contents, ship, magazine, small format. There's the other ships that are coming in the collection. There's a few more there than there were last time and in the previous issues, including the Europa, which I'm very much looking forward to. Again, let's put a box out, number again. Okay, let's open it up and have a little look inside. That's nice, bit of interesting artwork on the front of the magazine. That's very nice actually, I like that. Seeing it over a planet, nice view of the ship. Nice cover art. Same sort of deal for the inside. Apologies about the glare from the light. Pretty standard. I like that actually, that looks quite nice. The deflector dish artwork, I like that. That's very nice. Let's hope the model is to a similar sort of standard. It's nice, like the breakdown. Lots of detail, great artwork, print quality again, very good. Some concept bits and pieces. That's the Discovery Buran. That's quite nice. That's one that I've been thinking about because that's got a really nice colour scheme on it again as well. And the Discovery ships are of a slightly larger format, aren't they? So I don't know, maybe that's one for the future. Designing the ship. Yep. Bit about Star Trek Online, what's that? It's a character breakdown. Yeah, that's all about the game. Breakdown of the game, and same as the regulars, stats for the ship, and the upcoming issue, and a nice bit of artwork on the end. Again, like I say, the camera that I'm using has got a slightly different colour balance, so this is more turquoisey than the sky blue that you see there. Yeah, very nice. Right, let's have a little look at the ship. Again, it's the same blank cardboard box packaging, press fit. Oh, that's a lot of metal in that, that's quite nice. Yeah, I like that. Stand and the base. Stand is exactly the same as all the others, but just in case you're interested or nerdy about those sorts of things, 3246A/A. Very cool. And the mounting is rear post, so that's quite nice. And it's nice and straight. Okay, so let's have a little look at the ship. And this is the first time I'm seeing it as well, obviously, having just unboxed it. So that's the top. That's the bottom. Okay. Let's have a little look at the top. That's nice. You can actually read the nameplate this time. That decal isn't all folded over. And actually, that's a nice piece as well. That is actually part of the side ring on the saucer section at the front. That's really nice, I like that. Lots of little escape pods. They're actually moulded in relief. Lovely little red paint apps around the outside of them. The phaser strip. The little thruster points. They look slightly more red on the camera than I'm seeing them. They're slightly... Actually, no, they are kind of orangey-red. Okay. That's nice. So that's obviously where the bridge and command center is. Because the Buran's a funny one, isn't it, with the bridge not being in the midsection of the saucer, but being at the front here. So we see a bit of a wash gone onto it as well. Kind of a stone-coloured wash. But you can see there's actually some slight Aztec-ing in amongst that wash, or whether it's just spotty. No, that looks deliberate. That looks like there's actually some spotting in it, but I think that's deliberate because it's on both sides. That's quite cool. That's a really, really small detail. And again, you've got the same sort of, a carbon fiber style detailing for the Aztec-ing on the rear panels here. And that's present on all the grey panels. See the Buran name there on the side as well. That's very nice. Engines, or the nacelles, sorry. This nice orange polycarb. It's not quite as clear and shiny as this one. Yeah, it's slightly thicker and it's not quite as see-through. You can see this one is very, very clear. This one is a little bit more almost smoky. Still nice. Nice colour that stands out. Upper midsection here. Tiny, tiny little window details in that little yellow box, blue box there. Really is tiny. Some bit of detail into that rear section there. And then you've got these split nacelle structure. So there's the front profile of it. That's awesome. That looks really, really cool, that does. Yeah. Very Star Wars X-wingy and kind of like the fighters on Babylon 5 with the quad split nacelles at the rear. Yeah, that's kind of funky, that is. Like that. Speaking of the cells, let's carry on with a look at those. Yeah. That blue is really striking when it comes through. You can really, really see it. And again, that really intricate Aztec-ing detail on the dark strips at the rear here. registry at the end of the nacelles there. To the rear. There's no polycarb inserts inside the nacelles on this one. It's just the paint taps running down this spine piece here. Yes, there's no polycarb inserts inside the nacelles. There's the rear end here. Guessing because it's slightly odd and it doesn't seem to show it. But those two upright sausages there are supposed to be the rear engines, the impulse engines, which is that's a bit odd. There's no clear differential as to what's supposed to be the impulse engines and what's not on this, and I'm looking at the breakdown of the magazine while I'm talking to you and I can't see anything that denotes that either. That's a shame. But yeah, there's the rear end, loads and loads of detail in there. And it's solid. And then let's do the underside. Loads of little details with the escape pods here in this central section here. They're all raised and then they're ringed with that red. Nice bit of paint out through here. And then there's that for the inside of the, what I'm guessing is the deflector dish. Apologies for that. So that's what it looks like in the magazine, and that's what you get there. I guess putting a piece of plastic polycarb into that would be incredibly difficult. Not a lot of space in there. But the blue is bright and vibrant, I suppose. Sorry about the flickering there. The windows are in blue on the underside of the hull as well, which is kind of wild. And they're just painted on, so they're not molded and mist. It's quite nice. I don't know whether you can see it, but there's a faint trace of maybe the Starfleet Arch logo, maybe. It's a bit ambiguous. It's a bit tenuous as well, actually. That's probably just a couple of paint up lines as part of the design. I don't think they do anything quite that deep cut. But yeah, the lovely, lovely detail on it. Really is fantastic. Registries here, reversed fore and aft, port and starboard. That's really nice. Yeah. Big fan of that. I like that a lot. It's a great ship, and as you can see, that's a real stonker, that one. That's a lovely big ship. This is the other big one in comparison. I mean, obviously, there's a massive difference in the saucer size, but as far as the overall footprint of the ship, I mean, they're really good. Yeah. Slightly darker with the dark portions compared to on this ship. Same cross-hatching effect, but yeah. Very nice. Weight's good. Lots of metal in this one. The entirety of the saucer is metal. This lower section here feels... Yeah, so... Could be that this is plastic. Plastic. The upper section is all metal. And then this central section down through here is all metal as well. I'm trying to see where the joint is. Ah, there it is. So that there, apologies, something a little bit smaller. There is the joint. That's not too bad, that's quite good actually. And the joint actually around the saucer is almost invisible. That's really good. If that even is a joint. That might be the joint. So the whole of the outer ring of the saucer is metal. There, that's the bit that's plastic. So there's the joint running around the inside and up and around this forward section of the nose here. That's where the joint is. That's quite nice. And it's all on the underside, so it's definitely well hidden. And this one down through the inside between two nacelle pylons. That's quite well hidden as well. That's really good. Loads of great moulding details like these vent sections here, which are nice like grill sections. They're very good. And they're on both sides. That is excellent. Perhaps even inside the splits between the wings, or the nacelle pylons, which nice and solid, a little bit flexy in the lower half, but obviously the top half's metal, so there's no flex in there. The nacelles are all square. The paint apps in for the central section here are just brilliant. Super sharp. A tiny little bit of window detailing along here. A tiny bit of window detailing along here. The pennant and stripe there. And I tell you what, there is even... I don't know whether you can even see that. There is even some writing, United Federation of Planets, inside there. And USS Buran, as far as I can see. Here. USS Buran, United Federation of Planets. That is absolutely tiny. That's bonkers small, that is. That is really, really tiny. And it's done the same on both sides. I know that, as you might be able to see, the pennant is slightly obscuring the writing, but that is just so small. I'm not even that. I'm just amazed that they even bothered to put that on. That is absolutely tiny. That is so small. Jeez, that is really, really awesome. Is it got any other little hidden gems on the underside? can't see anything like that. Absolutely brilliant. I mean, that's one thing that I have to say about these online models. The attention to detail with the paint apps is just... I mean, it is in some cases above and beyond. I mean, for example, that having the writing down the side along where the pennant is, I wouldn't even have expected for that to be there. I know it's there in the shots in the magazine and in the game, but that's really, really good. Again, 20 quid's worth. If you're going to buy them, you're going to buy them anyway. And at £20 per, that's... I mean, if you think about... I don't know whether anybody's ever collected the X-Wing models from Fantasy Flight Games or the Star Wars Armada ships. Again, Fantasy Flight Games. I mean, those Star Wars ships, the detail is great and the quality of the production is great. But again, they're like... For the larger ones, they're... 50, 60, 70 more pounds. And the level of detail is pretty much the same as these. Accuracy to the original material is about the same as these as well. So yeah, value for money, if you're going to buy them, you're going to buy them anyway. I mean, I am. So, yeah. You definitely do get what you pay for. I mean, there's a lot of metal in these Star Trek Online ships. Especially some of the earlier Star Trek ships, some of the plastic is a little bit suspect. It's a little bit wobbly and weak. But this is nice. Very nice and strong. Good weight to it. I'll just put it into the stand. See how it looks. This goes. That doesn't quite seem right, does it? There's a lot of. It's in there, but whether I'd expect it to stay in there is another matter entirely. Definitely doesn't go onto the front, does it? Yeah, that's a little bit wibbly wobbly, that one. It sits very flat on the stand. As you can see there, there's very little rake on it. Yeah, that is... There's a good 2 mil of movement in that, and it's not the tightest fit in the world. For example, if you're comparing it to the Gagarin, I mean, that is a proper... That's a snug fit, that is. To get in there onto the stand, that's a real... Give it a push. But... Wow. They do look good together, don't they? That is... Very, very impressive. They do look very nice together. And just for the sake of, because we can, yeah, that's quite nice. They definitely do. I mean, especially these Starfleet ships. I mean, I haven't got any of the the other faction ships yet, like the Klingon Romulan faction ships. But these ones do look great sat next to each other. They do look absolutely brilliant. Yeah, that's a hell of a thing. Having these sat on the shelf with each other, they're going to look really, really good. And the height that this one is set, I mean, in comparison to this one, the top of the ship is just 55 mil off the deck. And this one is a good 75 mil off the deck. Yeah. This one's about 65 mil. So, at least if you're storing them on a shelf or on a display cabinet or something, you're not going to encounter the same problem that I've got, where you're constantly having to fiddle the ships to try to get one to sit slightly underneath the other one, which is a bit of a pain when you've got so many of them. Yeah. That does look very, very cool. Great looking, great feeling set of ships. Anyway, really happy with those. Again, I'll put the link in the description if you're looking to add this or any of the other Hero Collector ships to your set. And I look forward to speaking to you again when I receive the next ship. So thanks very much. Cheerio.